It's Late Night Saturday with Tim Cavanaugh. Tonight's guest, actor Larry Holden. The music of PMP. And now from Alumni Auditorium, here's Tim!
All right, thank you! Thank you very much! Thank you, folks! Nice audience, wow! Now, tonight's guest is an actor, writer, director, and producer, having appeared in such films as Batman Begins and television shows including CSI and ER. Won't you please welcome Larry Holden?
Thanks. Come on up.
Well, welcome to Vermont there, Larry.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I've never been here before.
You haven't?
No, we were in the Mediterranean and just came here blind to make the film.
Oh, you fool.
Yeah.
You left the Mediterranean just in time for winter then, huh?
Yeah, but almost a year now.
Yeah?
Yeah, my wife and I were going to make the film, our last film, there in the Mediterranean, changed our mind, and then we're trying to figure out where to go. And every time we researched, I like going to places I've never been.
Yeah.
Every time I went online, and it seemed like Vermont just kept coming up, you know?
They pay a lot of money on Google to make sure that happens, yeah.
It worked. Yeah. It worked. Yeah.
So you had never been here before, and did you land in Burlington? Did you land somewhere else? Well, obviously at the airport, but I mean...
I landed in the Mad River Valley, but
just
by chance. I mean, we just, my wife Han and I just kept looking for a house that we thought would be nice enough, and when we found one, we went.
Yeah. Are you guys skiers?
I'm not. She is.
Oh, that's why she found the house.
She calls the shots.
Yeah, absolutely. She's got that upper hand right
absolutely,
there.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah. Now, let's tell the folks at home and the folks here in the studio audience a little bit of background about you, because obviously you've got a very familiar-looking face, and you've been in a lot of different projects. We talked about Batman Begins when you came out with your introduction. You played against Katie Holmes. You were the district attorney in Batman Begins, as well as you were in Memento and Insomnia. And that's with Robin Williams and a cast of others.
And Al Pacino, yeah.
Yeah. That must have been great to work with Al Pacino.
It was a dream. It really was. We got on really, really well.
Did you really?
Yeah. Went out, spent a lot of time, played poker, you know, went out for drinks. Well, Al doesn't drink anymore, but yeah. It was really amazing to show up and work with somebody you used to watch as a kid and kind of...
Absolutely.
You know, impersonate, really.
Absolutely. Yeah. So you have quite a history in films and film works, and I know that you're very active as far as writing your own projects, but you also have a number of different shows on TV that you've done, and certainly folks are familiar with CSI and ER, and what are some of the other programs that you've done, and is there a favorite one that you've done?
Excuse me. God, I couldn't list them all, to tell you the truth.
Right.
a favorite one. I don't know, for me, to be honest, TV's really hard, you know?
Oh, tell me about it. Yeah.
I don't know, that would take some time. There's a lot of them to try to compare them and figure out the best one. I don't know.
Yeah, and you've done a lot of them, too. I mean, when we were researching you, I mean, your list goes on and on and on, which is wonderful, and that speaks volumes for the type of person you are and the actor that you are, because you're obviously sought after. And that's kind of what you've connected here locally with a local director and filmmaker, and he's just coming off a wonderful high of a film that he has done called Finding Providence.
Jason
Argento, who's a local filmmaker here in the state.
Great guy.
And he's a super guy, and I know that you guys really connected just like that.
We really did. I mean, he just wrote us an email and said a few things that he'd been up to. And we invited him out to the house because he just seemed like that nice of a guy. And, you know, 2 hours later, and I hadn't even read the script, and I said yes. And then, you know, he's nice enough to get me to do this, too, you know, to come on TV, which is kind of unnerving, really.
It's unnerving?
For me, yeah.
Oh, really?
You know, you have everybody staring at you, you know, for crying.
Oh, gee, you're right.
And you have to feel, you know, I feel like you have to be charming or witty or whatever. It's nerve-wracking. But anyways, he came out, and that's all it took. He's a great guy.
Are you saying that you're not a charming guy? Is that why?
Not at all.
Not at all. Really? Let's look to your wife. Is that true? Is that true? No, she's saying not at all. I bet you're a nice guy.
I'm okay. To her, I'm okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you're living in Vermont. Jason comes knocking on your door.
Simple as that.
Yeah, which is the case often in Vermont. Now, this film, in fact, we'll get the address from Jason a little bit later on. Thank you. But this film is going to be shot on location or around the Burlington area and in Vermont next April and May.
That's what they tell me, yeah.
Yeah, that's what they tell you. I don't know.
Well, I was already almost kind of booked in a way. And Hannah and I, my wife and I, decided a few years ago when I thought, you know, we can keep doing these big budget films and stocking away the money and all that. But I was finding that I wasn't really having as good a time as most people would probably think you would be. And we decided to go out of our way, if we could, and help people like Jason and his partner Steve Moss and all those guys. Like, for example, there was a guy that wrote me after Batman Begins a fan letter, and he wanted to know, he only had one question. Did he want to go to, should he go to film school or should he not?
Yeah.
And I said, well, why don't you just take that tuition and make your own movie? And he said, well, that's ridiculous. I need someone like you to be in it. And I have, like, you know, 12 grand. And I said, I'll do it, you know, and we hadn't seen the script, and I don't think that kid thought I was going to show up in Atlanta until I got off the plane, you know. But we really
dime?
Enjoy it. No, on his dime.
Yeah.
No, I'm not crazy, you know.
Well, you did move to Vermont.
But it really, in all seriousness, it really adds something to the experience, I think, for Jason and them. They seem so appreciative, and all I said was, you know, you got to give me, you know, I don't have a lot of playing in my schedule for next year because we've signed up to do a bunch of these.
Yeah.
You know, my accountant right now is ready to commit suicide, you know. But we really get a joy out of working with people wherever we go. Wherever we go, I try to find filmmakers that might want to, you know, need some help or in any which way. And if I can do it, I try to do it.
Because obviously you want, it sounds like you want people to succeed in something that you've been very successful in.
Exactly.
And yeah. These people have dreams, whether it's Jason, who's got a dream and wants to keep working with his profession. And by the way, we're going to be throwing up the website for him because we want people to go visit the website. We want people to learn more about
StoneWorksEntertainment.com.
Oh, there you go. See? Yeah, StoneWorksEntertainment.com. We'll throw that up.
They're great guys.
They are good guys. Yeah.
Great, great, great guys.
And, you know, Jason's kind of taken the state by storm a little bit here because he's coming out. He is a force.
Yeah.
And he's got a band. Did you know that?
Yeah, he's giving me CDs. This kid he's a worker. I shouldn't call him a kid. Sorry, Jason. And those are the people I gravitate to. And so we've been in other places where the high schools will ask me to come speak or something, and I'll literally look at the entire school and say, if somebody here has an interesting idea, I'll do your movie, you know, for a cup of coffee sometimes, you know, if I can fit it in, I'll do it. And a lot of times people don't jump on it. And Jason's credit, he jumped right on it.
Right, absolutely.
You know, he didn't come with that agenda, really. I think he came just to talk about some different things, and maybe it was in the back of his mind, I couldn't tell.
So was there something about the script that you saw, was it something that you liked it instantly, or was it more Jason, the person that he was representing?
It's the person. Like I said, I have such a different taste usually with films, you know. Kind of, I guess you might call them odd tastes, or I'm not sure what people would call them, but so I gave up on that.
Yeah.
Because in Hollywood for years, I mean, it's really heartbreaking. You'd think there'd be scripts lying around all over the place that really get you excited, but it's not true. I mean, the good scripts that come through, everybody's fighting like crazy to get them. So I gave up on trying to find those perfect scripts. Instead, working on my own films, I can get that enjoyment, like really hammering out a script that I enjoy.
Absolutely.
But working with people like him, I really find fulfilling.
Well, we wish you the best of luck. We wish you the best of luck living here in Vermont.
Thanks. We're loving it. We are loving it.
Good for you.
It's a gorgeous estate.
Good for you. And we're excited to learn more. Again, it's StoneWorksEntertainment.com is the website. We're anxious to hear more information about it. We know that Jason's going to be doing casting calls and things of that nature. But thank you, Larry, so much for being with us.
Oh, thanks so much.
It was such a pleasure. We'll be right back with more Late Night Saturday right after this.
Thanks so much.